Good morning students, today we are starting with the 6th unit of 12th class, that is General Principles and Processes of Isolation of elements. Now first question, which is coming very important from examination point of view, define mineral and ore. Answer: mineral is any combined state of the element which is found in the nature. It is a combined state of the element found in the nature. Then we have ore. It is that combined state of the element from which element can be extracted economically or profitably. Economicity or profitability means when we are extracting metal from the combined state, it should cost less than the market cost. If it is costing more than that, that is not a good process to carry out the metallurgy of the element. So we can say that all the minerals are ore, but every mineral is not ore. All the ores are minerals, but every mineral is not ore. क्योंकि कोई भी combined जो state है that is called as mineral, from which element can be extracted economically or not. But ores are only those mineral from which metal can be extracted economically or profitably. Now, why elements exist in combined state? This is a very simple question, and simple answer to this question is that all the elements, they don't have noble gas core. In their valence shell, they don't have the noble electrons which give stability to them. They don't have noble gas configuration. In order to achieve that, they have to combine with the other element to complete their octet. This is a very simple question. Or in other words, in terms of electrochemical series or electrode potential, the elements whose electrode potential is more than less than hydrogen, or which have negative anode value, they are highly electropositive metals and they have strong affection for the electronegative metals. For example, iron, its anode value is -4.4 volt, so it has strong affection for oxygen and sulfur. Therefore, iron exists as a Fe2O3, Fe3O4 or Fe2S or Fe3S. Because it has strong affinity for the electronegative element, so it combines with them in order to complete its octet and to acquire more stability. So elements exist in the combined state only due to achieve noble gas configuration and due to their high activity E0 values, I electropositivity you can say. Negative E0 values, they have tendency to combine with other elements and form minerals. So due to high electropositivity, they have net tendency to combine with other elements. That's why they generally exist in the combined state. Now we will mention some of the combined state of these some important elements. So let us mention the important states, important combined states of some element. For example, iron exists as hematite, Fe2O3, limonite, Fe2O3, and water, magnetite, Fe3O4, iron pyrite, FeS2, copper iron pyrite. This is a common ore of both copper as well as iron, CuFeS2, aluminium as bauxite, formula is Al2O3, 2 water. It also exists as cryolite, Na3AlF6. Then we have calcium as calcite, CaCO3 as gypsum, CaSO4, 2 water, potassium as carmelite, KCl, MgCl2, 6 water. Then we have lead as galena, EBS, mercury as cinnabar, HGS, ZnS. So these are few combined states of the elements. And these combined states are mainly because of the more electropositivity of the elements. They have the net tendency to combine with other elements and to give the combined states or minerals of these elements. Then we have the question, why do sulfides, they occur in the rocks, while halides, they are generally found in the seawater. Now, why sulfides of most of the metals, they are not found in the sea, they mostly exist in the rocks, but halides, why sulfides of elements exist in the rocks, but halides generally found in the sea? The reason for that is very simple, that rocks which are found on the hills, these rocks, they contain both sulfides as well as halides of the elements. When rainwater falls on these rocks, it dissolves halides of the elements in it, and sulfides, they being insoluble in water, they are not dissolved by the rainwater. And this rainwater, when comes in the river, and river meets the sea, these halides, they reach up to the sea. They go to the lakes, they go to the sea through river. And then sulfides, which were not dissolved by rainwater, they remain in the rocks. So this is the reason. This is due to insolubility of metal sulfides in water. They do not dissolve in rainwater. So remain in rocks. But halides, being water soluble, get dissolved in rainwater and are brought to the sea by river water. While sulfides, they remain behind in the rocks. Now, what are native elements? Tell some native elements which are found in the nature. What are native elements? Name some of them. Answer is native elements are those elements which are found in the pure state in the nature. It is due to their positive E-naught, they have less reactivity. So, exist in the pure state. ये कुछ native element हैं, platinum, gold, copper, sulfur. So they are found in the nature, in the pure state. They are not attacked by the any other element, copper, silver, platinum. They are generally found in the nature, in the pure state. Then we have a very important question. What is crushing of ore and grinding up of ore? Prior to the metallurgy, extraction of element from its ore, ore is first of all crushed into powder state by jaw crushers or by stamp mill method. This powdered ore is then finely grounded in a grinding mill, where it changes into a very thin powder, and this powdered ore is then subjected to concentration for extraction of element. So crushing and grinding involve crushing up of the ores and grinding up of our ore into powdered state by jaw crushers, by stamp mill method, or by some suitable grinders, and followed by concentration of the ore. Then we have next question. Define calcination and roasting. So after purification of the ore, the ore is first of all calcined. It is heated in very limited supply of oxygen, or sometimes in the absence of oxygen, to convert hydrated ore into oxide ore to remove water from the hydrated ore. Or sometimes carbonate ores, they are changed into oxide ores simply by heating in the absence of oxygen. So calcination involves heating up of purified ore, concentrated ore, in limited supply of oxygen. Or absence of oxygen. To get oxide ore. अगर और में आपके पास वाटर है, that water will be evaporated out on heating. अगर और कार्बोनेट फॉर्म में है, it will change into oxide form. So this is called as calcination. After doing calcination, we proceed to roasting. Now what is roasting of ore? Roasting of ore involves heating up of the ore in the excess of oxygen. So second part of this question is, what is roasting up of ore? B answer of B part of question 8, roasting. It involves heating up of sulfide ore in excess of oxygen to convert it into oxide ore and impurities of carbon, sulfur, phosphorus, arsenic get oxidized to their volatile oxides. Which escape as gases. For example, we have 4FeS2 heated with 11O2 oxygen, you get 2Fe2O3 plus 8SO2, it goes off. If sulfur is as impurity, it will be oxidized to SO2, it goes off. Carbon as impurity, it will oxidize to CO2. Phosphorus will go as pentoxide to P2O5. Arsenic will also go as arsenic pentoxide. So all the impurities, they go off in the form of volatile oxide and sulfide ore, that is changed into oxide ore. Now this oxide ore is suited for metallurgical operation of the metal. जो ore है उसके ऊपर आप metallurgical steps लगा के we will extract metal from that ore. So this is called as calcination and roasting. After doing calcination and roasting, we come to a very important question of refining the ore by liquation. Define liquation. This technique is used for concentration of the ore as well as for refining of the extracted metal. In case the ore has less melting point as compared to the impurities, or refined metal or extracted metal, if it has less melting point then the impurities, then such metal or ore, it is kept on the hearth of the furnace. Furnace ke floor ke upar, jo ki sloping hearth hota hai furnace ka, uske upar ore ko rakha jata hai, and then it is heated. सिंस मेटल एक्सट्रैक्टेड मेटल और ओर ऑफ द मेटल इट हैज लेस मेल्टिंग पॉइंट सो इट विल मेल्ट अर्लियर बिफोर द मेल्टिंग ऑफ द इम्प्यूरिटीज एंड व्हेन दिस मेटल और एक्सट्रैक्टेड मेटल और ओर विच वॉज हैविंग लेस मेल्टिंग पॉइंट इट मेल्ट इट स्लाइड्स डाउन द स्लोपिंग फ्लोर ऑफ द फर्नेस एंड कम्स डाउन देन इट इज यूज फॉर मेटलर्जिकल ऑपरेशन. So what is liquation? It is used to purify ore metal with less melting point. The impure ore metal is kept on the sloping floor of the furnace and is heated, then ore or metal melts and slides down, ये पिघल जाएगा और पिघल कर नीचे आ जाएगा, leaving behind impurities. इम्प्योरिटीज को पीछे ही है छोड़ देगा. तो ये प्रोसेस इस तरीके से चलाया जाता है. दिस ओर इज केप्ट ऑन द स्लोपिंग फर्नेस, स्लोपिंग हार्ट ऑफ द फर्नेस. दिस इज इम्प्योर ओर और मेटल इट इज हीटेड फ्रॉम इलेक्ट्रिक बर्नर और सिंपल बर्नर. दिस इज बर्नर where ore or metal it will melt and will slide down. It will be collected here, molten ore or metal will come here and the impurities they will remain behind. This technique is called as liquation technique. Then we have 10th question. What is zone refining? This method is used to get ultra high pure metals like germanium and gallium. These metals they are used as semiconductor in electronic devices. When these metals they are purified by means of zone refining. In this method the impure metal is cast into a bar. This is impure metal bar. And this is heated with a moving circular heater. एक circular heater इसके चारों ओर लगाया जाता है और उसको आगे मूव किया जाता है. As soon as heater moves to this end, all the impurities they get collected towards this end and pure metal will remain behind. So this method is based upon the phenomenon when impure metal is heated with a moving circular heat, the metal as well as the impurities they both get melted and the impurities have more tendency to remain in the molten state for a long time. So they move along with a moving circular heater and they move towards one end along with that moving circular heater. While as soon as the moving circular heater is removed from this part, it comes to this part, the metal left behind that will get solidified. So by the end when you reach here, when your moving circular heater reaches from this terminus to this terminus, the whole of the material which is associated near this moving circular heater, that will be of impurity. And metal, solidified metal will be left behind. So in this manner the pure metal comes to one corner and impurity to another corner. So this method zone refining is highly effective to get the metals like germanium as well as gallium, which are used as semiconductor in electronic devices.